Gemini, welcome to your monthly overview. I hope all is well and fabulous for you. I do want to let you know, I actually did a reading for you earlier, and I scrapped it. All right. It was serious to the point of painful, and I didn't think how it could help the collective. I will say this. If you experience loss in the physical realm, okay, I'm sorry. That was pretty much the theme for 30 minutes. So, again, if you experience loss, I'm sorry. That is critically happening somewhere in Gemini's life. Some Gemini's life. I do want to acknowledge it. Because real terror reflects real life. But I thought it was difficult to the point of pain. So, I decided to do it. Alright? What's going on? I have to make those decisions as a reader. I do. And I do it carefully. And I wouldn't do it if I didn't think it was correct. Now, having said all that, we are big boys and big girls. We understand to take what resonates and to leave what does not. Reverse energies as it applies, always. Alright? What's going on? The monthly overview, oh my. The monthly overview can concern itself with love, sexuality, coin. I never know. That's why we're here. Could be a combination of those things. Let's take a look. What's going on? What's going on? Show me that current energy, please, for Gemini. Show me that current energy, please, for Gemini. What's going on? The moon. Let me know if you're dealing with Pisces or if you have Pisces in your chart, which case, pay attention. Current energies, there's some shit that has not come to the surface yet. I hopefully you're working on it since it is in your starter position. Hopefully we're working through our moon energy. So the moon energy down here, it's pretty well depicted as in the traditional tarot of the moon energy, which makes no sense. If I'm being honest with you, that's why I like different decks. They have better interpretation sometimes. So here we're seeing, you know, somebody who's in the depths of the ocean. The idea is to burst to the surface, that way we can live appropriately, okay, and we can see and we can move and we can feel. But when we're in the depths of the water, we're always in this place of we can't get through it. We just can't. We're surrounded by our own emotionality and the hidden depths of things, and we're not in a place where we can exist in that. So the idea is to break through the surface, and that way we can live and we can breathe again, okay. So what is important for Gemini to understand at this time? It's in your starter position, so hopefully we're not living in that delusional, murky water energy. I don't know what's going on. I don't know anything about this. Uh-huh. What is important to you at this time? Could be your person. What is important to Gemini at this time? Ten of Swords. Jeez Louise. This is what we're not trying to deal with. I have to take it. I have to take it. The first one, that was difficult even by my standards as a reader. This seems to have a little more direction. I can already tell you that. What is important for you to understand, there seems to be an ending in sight here, or an extreme amount of pain, and it's something that we are trying to learn, accept, or work through. Okay. What are the fears, please, for Gemini at this time? What are the fears, please, for Gemini at this time? That's an interesting fear. Some of you quite literally connect with the Leo, and in which case you have a reflection of their energy. Two of Cups, where the contract is concerned. You either fear losing this energy, okay? That's not what I'm feeling. That's not what I'm feeling. Do I have the strength? Will I ever have the strength to take on this Two of Cups, somebody that you do want? Okay. Will they take me on? Will Gemini take me on? Can I take them on? You might have some Leo in your chart. There's a protective quality here too. You're protective of somebody, but you're not allowed to show it. That was so oddly specific. That's so oddly specific. That would make perfect sense to me if you're already in a contract and you don't want to lose it, especially if you feel like there's an ending in sight and that's something you're not trying to deal with, in which case that makes perfect sense. But do I have the fear to go after, do I have the strength, because it's in your fear category, to go after the one I actually want? Okay, let's find out. We're going to need to clarify. There's a truth here. There is a truth here underlying all this. What is supporting Gemini at this time? What is supporting Gemini at this time? There's a protective quality here. Protective quality surrounding this Two of Cups. I need to see what the heck that is. Very protective. What is supporting Gemini at this time, please? What is supporting Gemini, please? Loss, regret. It's for some of you. What is supporting? I want it to be just right. Temperance, patience is supporting you. Temperance or literally a Sagittarius. Could literally be. Power card shows up in that. Yeah, it could literally be a Sagittarius that is supporting you. But really, it's a sense of take it off the zodiac grid, and it's really just patience, a sense of patience with yourself, the circumstances, the situation. Have patience with yourself. This is what's supporting you. Obstacles. Three of Swords under the bottom of the deck. Some of you have a Three of Swords associated with Sag. What are your obstacles, please? What are your obstacles? What are Gemini's obstacles, please? What are Gemini... Okay. Moving forward. Six of Swords. Moving forward. Doing the healing, showing ourselves patience, and then actually acting on it. Six of Swords, moving it forward. You don't know if you can do it. You don't know if you can do it because it would require you to make an active decision here. Show me the future or outcome. The world. Yes, things are changing. Four of Cups is the underlying issue. We are emotionally unhappy, dissatisfied. That is the underlying current into all this. Okay. There is something here. I dare say there's even a protective quality to it, but it doesn't feel engaged. Why doesn't it feel engaged? You want to protect that source. You want to protect the source of love. You want to protect that source of love. Show me what I need to see, please. Show me what I need to see, please. I need to protect that source of love. It's, what the hell is that? Show me what I need to see, please. Show me what I need to see, please. What's going on, please? Show me the best possible clarification for Gemini. Show me what I need to see, please. Oh, it's coming in fast, huh? What's going on, please? There it is. Queen of Swords. Some of you are consciously aware that you're waiting for somebody else's energy. Consciously aware of it. That doesn't mean that you're happy or sad about it, but you are aware of it. Show me what I need to see, please. Show me what I need to see, please, for the best possible clarification for Gemini. You want to move forward to somebody. Two of Wands. Somebody that you have communications with, possibly flirtations. Show me what I need to see, please. Show me what I need to see, please. Some of you need to move on literally from a Sag. Show me what I need to see, please. What's going on? Show me this moon energy. Why is that here? What is the moon energy? I do believe this is something you're coming to terms with. Yes, good. King of Swords, good. Confirmation, excellent, good. No, I'm pleased with that. I am pleased with that. You're coming to terms with your moon energy, the shit that's buried way down. You're doing it from your headspace, which is comfortable for you. That is your air element. The King of Swords, you are coming to realization of your moon energy, which is what? What is the moon energy here? What is the moon? Time for a new chapter. The Fool. The start of something new. It needs to be addressed. Somebody's going to have to get the cojones and address this shit. Move forward on it, all right? It's going to feel like somebody's nipping at your ankles, biting you, trying to hold you back, but it has to happen. This has to happen. This has to happen. Somebody's got to get the nerve and say what they need to say. Show me this Ten of Swords. What is important to you? The Ten of Swords. What is important for you to understand? The Ten of Swords. What about it? Show me the Ten of Swords, please. Somebody's got to get the nerve to say this. There's an ending here and a Knight of Cups. Somebody has to open this shit up. Somebody has got to. It's going to take work to get through the pain. Show me the vulnerability. Vulnerability how? Show me the vulnerability how? Somebody has to get through the pain and speak the truth. Okay? About this ending. Nine of Cups. I never said what would make me happy. I didn't. I was too afraid to change things. I was too afraid to change things. Somebody's got to get the nerve to speak their truth. There was silence. There was silence when there should have been words. there was silence when there should have been words. And it caused pain. It caused an inordinate amount of pain. Technically an ending. It looks like an ending. But it's really just... it could have been prevented by either you or them. I don't know who. I can't tell. The energy entanglement is here. Somebody's coming to term with their moon thoughts in a very decided, factual way. They have got to take a risk to express this. The everything I could not say. By default, someone's inability to speak their truth, their feelings, their wants, their wishes. The Nine of Cups is here, the expectations. Somebody's unwillingness to make change, to leave their comfort zone, to get outside their normative, to get outside their script is what caused the pain. But what looks like an ending, but it's really pain. That's what really caused it here. Somebody's inability to be open the fuck up. It was that. This is what I really want. This is what I really want. And it's like I couldn't get comfortable with getting out of my comfort zone. I don't know how to open up. I don't know how to talk like you. I don't know how to talk like you. I don't know how to just say things like you do. I don't know how to just say I want this. Something like that. I don't know how to talk like you. I don't know how to express myself like you do. It's easy for you. It's not for me. Something like that. Something like that. So I don't know that this is an ending, Gemini, so much as it is pain. It's just a great deal of pain here. Okay, Five of Pentacles. Yeah, it caused the disconnect. For real. Is it over? Over? I don't know. Because somebody is looking like they're getting some serious nerve up to talk about this. I don't know. Could be you or them. The fears. Show me. Will this person be too proud? Will they talk to me? Show me the strength, please. But there's also a protective quality here. This is Two of Cups. This is my Two of Cups. Show me strength. Nine of Wands. But there it is again. Blockage. Fuck, man. Blockage. Somebody can't... Okay. Do you see that? He's covering her mouth. You said too much, but I also can't say what I need to say. You've said too much. There's an accusation. I'm telling you, this is the conflict right here. I saw it right here, man. Right here. Somebody's coming to terms, and I do believe this is you, coming to terms with your moon energies, at least with your real thoughts, with the sword energy. And you're like, you know what? I'm doing this. I'm going to be the fool. Because there's something here. I don't know about the ending. Technically, on the surface, it looks like an ending. But the energy is still entangled. The energy is still entangled despite there being an ending here. So I'm interpreting this more as pain. Somebody had an inability to open up and say, this is what I want. I don't know how to talk like you. I don't know how to talk like you. And I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I don't know how to talk like you. You can put it all out there. She is. That's all well and good for you, but that's not who I am. I don't know how to do that. And I'm sorry I caused the disconnect. Something like that. It's like it's so easy for you, but you don't know how hard it is for me. Something like that. Something like that. And it's taking strength to do this. And you don't know if you have the strength. Somebody doesn't know if they have the strength to come forward, despite the inclination being here. So you two are still very much... See, this. They've thought about it 1,000 times. Seven of Cups. This is what I really think. This is what I really feel. They thought about it 1,000 times. That they still haven't come forward yet. Also in association with kissing with this person. The strength, you got to get the strength up. Somebody got to get the strength up to do this. Somebody got to get the strength up to do this. If, you know, if the accusations were thrown at you, Gemini, just tell me what you want. Tell me how you feel. And you just couldn't. Then it's that way, or it's the other way around, whatever, man. All I know is that the energy entanglement is real. It's ongoing, despite the fact that it looks like an ending on the surface. So show me this Two of Cups. Of course, it's a soul bond. That's why there's still energetic entanglement, is because it's a soul bond. And show me the Two of Cups, please. Oh, yes. It wasn't, honey, it weren't for lack of passion, and it wasn't for that. It was not for that reason. The other person thinks it was because you weren't attracted to them or something like that. Because there is it's the Two of Cups, man. Somebody is fiercely attracted here. We are fiercely attracted to each other. The Queen of Wands and the Nine of Pentacles, fiercely attracted with the soul bond energy, I might point out to you. It wasn't just about love, lust, entanglement, handsomeness, beauty, etc. It was also a Two of Cups thing. It's like somebody gets so choked up on their words. Man, somebody gets so choked, like all they can do is feel, they're more comfortable physically feeling, but not emotionally expressing. If I could just show you how I felt, but that didn't happen either. What the fuck? They've thought about addressing this 1,000 times. I am still attracted to you. I want your physical energy. It had nothing to do with that. It had nothing to do with that. It had nothing to do with that. Something like that. It had nothing to do with that. The other person then might think that you didn't have the interest in them. Well, it's like, fuck, if so-and-so was really into me, they'd tell me, right? Or they'd demonstrate it physically, but that didn't happen either. Damn. And dude, seriously, the strength of this, it's so high in the fear category. Yeah, somebody's stubborn insistence on being quiet and silent is what caused the heartbreak. That's it. That's the summary. I'm the Emperor. I know who I am. I know what I'm about. And I insist upon thus caused this Three of Swords on the split. Show me what I need to see, please, for the best possible clarification for Gemini. Show me what I need to see, please. Show me what I need to see, please. But here's the news. Here's the good news. All right. Somebody's coming to terms with this harshly and critically. And by God, they're going to do something about it, too. That's what it looks like. It's just the fears are so substantial. Getting the words out. There is love here. There is fierce attraction here. There's even a practical element here. I do believe somebody seeing the other person as hot, attractive, independent, confident, and the other person doesn't have those same language skills. You know what I'm saying? It's not for lack of connection. That's not it. It's like, well, fuck, I guess so-and-so is not connected to me, because if they would, they'd make good on it. And the other person could not or would not. Something like that. Something like that, man. It's like every time this person tried to speak, they shut it down. As soon as they got the nerve up, they shut it down. And now they're having to come to terms with their moon thoughts. Show me temperance, please, as the supporting energy. Showing yourself time, temperance, consideration. You know, blocking. Seven of Wands. Defending your position also. How so? Defending your position, how so? Show me. Defending the position, how? Knight of Pentacles, there was a reasoning behind this. There was a reasoning behind this. I was defensive. I was warming up to it. There you are at the bottom of the deck, underlying that as I said that. I was warming up to it. I was warming up to it. What? I was warming up to it. I was warming up to it. I needed more time. I was warming up. I was on the precipice. I was getting closer to this. This is what you're coming to terms with. I needed more time. I was warming up to this. I'm not like you. I'm not like you. Something like that. You're confident and you know what's going on and you make decisions and that's great, but I was warming up to this. I don't have the same... I was warming up to this. So I was defensive, but I was warming up to it. I was trying. I was trying to get there. Something like that. This is what you know to be true. This is supporting you. Show me the Six of Swords, please. The obstacles moving forward. How so? Six of Swords moving forward. How? How so? Moving forward and what? With confidence. Okay. 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 We gonna do this, huh? Show me. Show me. Show me. Show me. We're moving. We got two movement cards now. Six of Wands over the Six of Swords. Yeah. Our confidence is picking up. This is kind of the obstacle here. Again, there's a confidence issue. Somebody's like, that's all well and good for you. And I know who... I'm glad you know who you are and what you're about. That's awesome. I know it's a Two of Cups. Yes, I'm grossly attracted to you. I want your physical energy, but I could not get to the same place that you were at the same time. I needed more time. I was still warming up. How long this went on, I don't know. I don't know. Gemini, it could be upwards to a year. I am seeing year references. I am. this might be one of those energies that really does need a substantial amount of time. I don't know. I don't think you did either, because I saw the disconnect. It was clear. Show me that 6/6, please, is the obstacle. Doing this. I feel like this person is trying to challenge themselves. Show me that 6/6. How is this? They're making the decision. Somebody's got to make the decision with that Page of Cups and Judgment, because there's no such thing as divine timing, not in this context. I feel like somebody took a lot of time, as it were. And if that's their energy, then that's their energy, but already consumed so much time that that became the point of contention. Somebody has to make the active decision to be vulnerable, to put that cup out there, to be tentative, even if it's a little shy, I don't fucking care. Somebody's got to make the decision to do this. And it's either yours or theirs. I do believe it's yours, because this is under your obstacles category, but moving forward with confidence, about making a decision to communicate what looks like a very important truth. And it's labor intensive, and it's taken time. Okay, show me the world. Mm-hmm. Show me the world, please, as the outcome. Three of Swords. The longer we delay, the more the pain. Okay, what else, please? What about it? I do believe we're healing to this love option. Why are you showing me this? What's the point? What was the point of showing me this? Show me this Four of Cups, please. I don't know why I'm being shown this. Because as far as I can tell, nobody's going to do it. I don't think it's going to happen. It's kind of like, well, fuck, it's over. Three of Swords over the world. As far as I can tell, because this is an obstacle, I don't think you or this other person could overcome it. It just can't. Somebody addressed their moon energy, and that's wonderful. They even have a certain strength of conviction behind it. But there's not enough time in the world for this person. Gemini, and perhaps that's the point. Or you. Reverse energies. For some of you, Gemini, there's just not enough time in the world for you to come to terms, to get the confidence up, to say what you need to say. I don't know. For somebody, there's just not enough time in the world. And it's like, I would rather end this thing with heartbreak than come forward. Show me the Four of Cups. So, the Four of Cups remains overall emotionally dissatisfied. I don't know what the point is, other than, you know, if some of y'all are waiting on an apology, an explanation about why somebody couldn't get their energetical shit together, despite the massive potential here. Show me this Four of Cups, remaining emotionally dissatisfied about an offer that was not taken. The Ace of Pentacles. It will always be that, and there was the stubborn insistence to. Stubborn insistence, clinging to the insecurity. It's looking on that pentacle like it's long ago and far away. Look at that expression on her face. Oh well. Okay. And yet the action, the potential here is quite massive to balance up. The potential is wonderful. In terms of at least balancing up, sharing perspectives appropriately. Action for action, meeting in the middle ground, Six of Pentacles. What's behind that? Queen of Swords, at least having an honest conversation about balancing up. Even then, that would be welcome to nothing at all. Apologies, I had a disruption. I had to get the pen so I could write a note. This is where you left off. Yeah. This sucks. Some of you are haunted by an offer that you would love to make, even if it's just to get together to balance out the equation and share somebody's side of the equation that was left unspoken. And it's like, well, that would be nice, but never gonna happen. Or this is just what you feel like you're haunted by with the underlying issue. You know? Looking out for that huge offer. It might have been made once upon a time. I don't know. I do know this. The fear category, which by all rights should be fierce and loving and what looks like a glorious connection. I mean, a glorious, strong connection is under your fear category. The strength of this connection scares the shit out of somebody. And, fuck. That sucks. The strength of this connection scares the shit out of somebody. Somebody's thought about it 1,000 times. Somebody's thought about this conversation 1,000 times. Everything that wasn't said. It's all well and good for you to just throw your stuff out there. Good for you. That's just not who I am. I don't know how to get to it. And there is some low-level resentment of the other person's ability to kind of just freely express themselves, because this person has a very high respect for self-expression. Okay. There is some kind of resentment there, but it's mostly stemming from knowing the other person can't. So it's not really angry with the other person so much as somebody else is so inhibited or prohibited from saying what they really want. It's like there's an underlying resentment of the other person just by default of what the other person can't do or tells themselves they can't do. The pain here, I don't even see this as an ending so much as it's just pain. Because somebody couldn't open the fuck up about what they really wanted because they couldn't get out of their comfort zone. That's it. There's a certain sense of, it's always been this way, it's always going to be this way. I don't know how to break out of that script. I don't know how to break out of that normative. I don't know how. How? I don't know who the hell came to term with their moon energy. They're doing, the knowledge is here. And there's even an inclination to take off and try. You even understand what the issue is. Somebody understands what the issue is quite distinctly. Distinctly. But the fear, the strength of this connection is so much it overwhelms or intimidates the other person. And they shut down. If you can believe it, this is an improvement from the reading I scrapped. I would still like to know what the fucking point is, because it looks like somebody's choosing pain and fantasy, a resignation to healing, kind of like, even the obstacle implies movement, but that would require me putting myself out there, and we've already established that's hard for somebody, really fucking hard. We've already established that's a no-go for somebody. It requires an active decision on somebody's part to put themselves out there, even in the smallest swarm, and we've already established someone can't do that. What's supporting you is this idea, I just needed more time. How much time? Who needs this much time? I'm looking upwards to a year or more. I'm working my way up to it. Just give me more time. Give me more time. This is an insistence on somebody's part. This was support. I was working my way. I was warming my way up to it. Because what I see is slow movement with blockage, boundaries, difficulties. You know, Just work with me, meet my terms and conditions, they could never be met. Just give me more time. Just give me more time to warm up. And the underlying is that somebody here is perpetually dissatisfied with an offer not given, not received, not expressed in the real world. That's not expressed in the real world. Or one that was not taken. Fuck. Energetically, you two are connected, even though you're separated. And it's stemming simply because someone can't speak up. That's it. So even I lost my patience there. So what's the point of this? That's the idea. Spirit wants somebody to see. There's not enough time in the world for somebody. The timing is now. There's no such thing as divine guidance or timing, except for when we're unaware of it. This person is distinctly aware of their inability to make a decision or speak their piece. There will be no divine rescue in this person's case. That's not how it works. Divine guidance happens without us knowing it. Anything else defeats the purpose. What else, please? Yeah, if you can believe it, this one's still an improvement, though, of the other one I scrapped. Let me tell you, you think this one was hard? Trust me. That's what this comes down to. Also, the reflection of judgment. Judgment is 20. Decision, the truth. The truth, 20. That's it. That's what this all boils down to. So, therefore, it's an Empress, too. That's why it's such a big deal. The Empress energy. Taurus Libra does not have to be. This could just be the representation of that person. There's a certain strength behind it. I mean, this somebody fears the strength of this connection like a lot. Grossly sexually attracted. That's more than that. It's more like this person's fire and determination is some... It's overwhelming. You want to get your hands on it. But you don't dare. It's intimidating even. That's because they're an Empress. Somebody's Empress here.